do you want to come over and see how I do it? Make sure it's cold water, of course. You may want to wear gloves when you do this, but I don't mind the chlorine. I actually like the smell of it. Probably got used to it over the years. See how simple that was? Much easier than the old way.
What was the old way?
The Artemia farms, the setting up of the light, getting the swing of the light, then siphoning them out. And if you're doing that with 300 angelfish, and you've got, say, 10 tanks with 300 angelfish, it's just you can't do it. Okay, they've been decapsulated.
Do you ever use a chlorine remover at all?
No. That's them all decapsulated. That's all fish food. Nothing but fish food.
Just like pits.
The shell's just gone down the drain.
Can those things in the freezer? Put it in the freezer?
I've never tried it. It's fish food, you could freeze it. I'll just do this. They're actually quite expensive, so it's best to get as much out as you can. Now this is the soggy water.
How long will that last?
We try and use it within 3 months, and yeah, that would only last us about 6 weeks. When we're in full production now, I haven't got any fish, so yeah, no use for it.
Do you keep it in the fridge?
Or? Keep it in the fridge. Even, where's the little fire? That one. Even that, the dry ones, I keep in the fridge.
So this is freshly packed, so it's very small, good for small fish.
Good for small fish.
You can grow these up to the full size.
You can grow them up, but that's another ball game again. We'll touch on that in a few minutes, but
okay.
We'll get this part out of the way first. Now, that's fresh water in there, because I didn't have enough salt, but for the demo I can show you anyway. When we're harvesting, it depends how many fry you've got. You pick it up and put it in. I won't bother wasting it because it's no good putting it in fresh water. But hang on, I can do it actually. Depends how much you want. Okay? I've got some at the top there, so I'll just get. Oh, we use a wine bottle. Originally, we use a Coke bottle, but the Coke bottle's got the four little pockets down the bottom. You get dead spots in the current. If you use a wine bottle, it works. Use one of those little uplifts downlift off a air filter. Goes down and reaches the bottom. I've pre-adjusted that. It's not coming here at all. But than according to the
Definitely.
Okay, that's about the flow rate, Janine. A lot of I've heard people.
Bruise them up, get them going.
It keeps them off the bottom. If they settle on the bottom, they're going to die. I've heard people talk about using an air stone, but Sid Adams, one of our members, pointed out to me years ago that the vine shrub, as they pass the air stone, they're actually crashing into it, and it actually breaks them down, and you lose them. So, just like that. Every now and again, you'll get a build-up of salt in the end, and just a little skewer, put it down there to get the salt out of it. And what we did, we had three bottles, so this would be made up in the morning, and put a peg on it. In the evening, there's another bottle made up, the following morning, another bottle. The following evening, that one's ready to use. So you take the peg off, you move it to this one, and so on, you do that. That way you know which one's the fresh one, or which one's the oldest one to be using.
That's for three feedings a day?
No, it's one feeding a day.
Right.
But you know, like what's there would have been enough for one batch of angels.
Yeah.
Or I'd put a hell of a lot more in because I've got 10 batches on the go. Depends on what you need.
Yeah. So does it take 3 days to mature then?
No. You do the first one in the morning, second one in the evening, third one the following morning, then in the following evening, which is what, 36 hours later, the first batch is ready to go. We have done it in the morning of the second day, but having the three bottles, you've always got them.
So you prefer them being live rather than just viewing them the decapsulated ones?
If they're live, it triggers the fish's hunting habit. And they'll go more for a live food than they will for something instead, but everything in that bottle can be used as fish food. So we'll imagine now that's been running for 36 hours. I'll just switch it off. And if that peg goes onto the next bottle. I'll just pour that down and see if it's only water. Not contradicting what I say, we've already said before about rinsing them. Thoroughly rinsing them. I wouldn't bother. Well, I don't bother. What I do now is I just get it like that and dip it in each tank. And that I can put back into there because it's nothing on it. Now that the water in that bottle is the one. It's got to be the same specific gravity as salt water. And if you get yourself a hydrometer, if it's in the green zone, it'll work. Or 35 grams of salt per litre of water.
And with the salt, is that just common
cool salt?
Sodium chloride, or do you use any special salt?
Buy a big bag of salt for bones.
Cool salt.
Could you use like marine tank salt? I mean, it's pretty too expensive to do it for a large volume.
Well, if you've got a marine fish tank, just get the water out of the tank, because it should be fine. And you could probably hatch them in there.
Mm-hmm.
If they weren't eaten by the fish, you'd be up when they hatch, the fish will take them. Any questions at all on that?
How many eggs did you put into the mixture?
There was four tablespoons there. We normally do six. That's why it turns so quickly. It usually takes about 10 minutes. And if you're getting close to the 10 minutes and it hasn't changed, just add a little bit more chlorine.
4 tablespoons, 4 cups of water and 2 cups of chlorine.
Yep. And yeah, just scale it down.
I did it the old way. Freaking nightmare.
It's not worth the trouble.
And the original eggs, you buy them in that tin, do you, Terry?
No, we buy them like that. That tin cost me $135 from Age of Aquariums. We have paid up to $300 about 10 years ago. I had to pay $300 for a can because there was a problem collecting it in my bio from the salt lakes. And I've paid as little as $70 for it, which would be about 3 years ago. So So yeah.
How long would that tin last you?
About 9 months.
When I was in full production.
That's
with a lot of tanks going though, isn't it, Terry?
I had 100 fish tanks, and there was 6 fry raising tanks, and then there was a dozen juvenile tanks, and they were nearly always full of angels. If you went to my place, there was thousands of angels. I don't have much more I can say on that. As you can see, it was pretty simple. I didn't get chlorine on myself, and that's all fish food. It's the easy way of doing it.
So you can feed that, and you can also hatch it.
Yep.
Right.
Towards the end there, where I got to the stage where I didn't need this anymore, I had a lot of it left. I had some young stuff that I was growing on for the guy that was bought them off me. I was actually taking it straight from there with the salt and putting it in the tanks. If you do regular water change, it's that little bit of salt you're putting in there. Sorry to contradict you by saying, but that's just my way of doing it. That little bit of salt, if you're doing regular water changes, especially with the fry tanks, the bottom of the fry tanks were always vacuumed every day using one of those. Okay? So the salt wasn't a problem.
So does the, when you say decapsulating, does it actually melt the casing? The chlorine?
I think it actually burns it off.
Okay. And that's why when you put it through the sieve, it basically just runs away.
Yeah. Cool. The water changes to a browny colour.
Yeah.
And yeah, it only takes a few seconds to rinse off.
So it's cheaper to do it this way than to buy the pre-decapsulated.
Oh. If you buy pre-decapsulated, I don't know what they cost these days, but when I was working at Midland years ago, I think it was about $30 for a little tube of it.
Yeah. And this is the same thing.
I was selling those for $4 to the shops. And the same thing with the same, about half as much decapsulated, I was selling for $6.50 to the shops. And I brought along some of those, which I've given to the club. What was left in the can I haven't got a use for, so that's going to the club, and that is also going to the club. Have fun with it. There's empty vials to decanted.
Would you raise those angels purely on that? That's
as for the first month, it's the only
first
thing.
Month. Yeah.
Terry, you said you would sell the decapsulated ones to the shops.
Yep.
So did you dry them out?
No.
And then so you kept them in the salt mixture, and then put them in the vials and sold them like that.
I've actually got a little spoon here. One second.